Let's now talk about EPDs, environmental product decorations. We often get asked a lot what these actually are. So just give us the simplest way to understand them.
Sure. So in construction and manufacturing, we're seeing this fundamental shift toward data-driven sustainability. And construction EPDs are transforming environmental reporting from these kind of vague claims that you might see in a sustainability strategy on a website into verified and comparable data. And when we assess a building material or a product, an EPD can show us its complete environmental impact from raw material extraction through manufacturing through various end-of-life scenarios. And this comprehensive view comes from a life cycle assessment. And what's cool is that EPDs are rigorous, they're standardized, they follow specific ISO protocols. And this standardization is really critical because when every EPD follows the same rules, you can make accurate comparisons between different materials.
So then, who are EPDs for and who gets value from them?
Well, for architects and engineers, that means confident decision making based on real data. For manufacturers, it's a verified way to demonstrate environmental performance, and every EPD has a 5-year validity period. So EPDs are important for everything from LEED or BREEAM certification to procurement requirements. And an EPD isn't just documentation, it's really a fundamental tool for measuring and reducing environmental impact in construction.
Let's break down the different types of EPDs because this is where people might get a bit confused.
Sure. So there's three main types that cover different life cycle stages of a product. The first is so-called cradle to gate, and this is a baseline EPD. It covers manufacturing and raw materials only. So you can think of it as telling the story of your product up until it leaves your factory. Then there's also the so-called cradle to gate with options approach, and this includes some additional information modules. And then there's the final cradle to grave option. And this is a full story. It covers everything from raw materials to maintenance, all the way through recycling or disposal at end of life. And this is what most construction projects actually need because it gives the complete picture.
So, like, not all EPDs are alike then.
No, I mean, no, they're not. EPDs are built around life cycle assessment practice and methodology, but their scope can vary.
Right. So, today I really want to talk about why businesses actually need EPDs beyond just doing the right thing, for the environment.
Yeah, I think the reality is that EPDs just help you do business. So the EU requires them for public procurement. Belgium actually requires them for environmental marketing claims. And other countries around the world are just going to follow suit. So if you're going after LEED certification or BREEAM certification, EPDs are actually one of the most cost-efficient ways to earn credits. But what's really interesting is that companies are finding that EPDs do indeed give them a competitive edge.
How so? What do you mean by that?
Well, when you have the verified environmental data about your product, you can differentiate yourself in the market. You can optimize your manufacturing processes to create more environmentally friendly products. And most importantly, you can access projects that have strict environmental requirements. So companies that are investing in EPDs now are positioning themselves ahead of where the market is already clearly heading. And it's not just about compliance, and it's not a cost burden. It really is growing your business opportunity with an EPD while also making an environmental difference that's positive as well.
Thank you. So, like, one of the biggest questions we get asked is about the practical side of things. So, let's walk people through how EPDs are actually created.
Sure. I think it can be very intimidating, and we hear from a lot of folks out there that this is sort of a scary process to get started, but you can boil it down to 5 steps. So the first is data collection, and just this is a lot of data. It's gathering everything from your products, raw material, energy use, waste, transportation, just anything that impacts its environmental footprint. And then next, you conduct a life cycle assessment or LCA. And that's where you analyze all of that data following specific product category rules. And you can think of it as following a recipe. In a recipe, you need to do something exactly right for the recipe to turn out well. And within an EPD, you have to do these exactly right for it to count. After that, you prepare a detailed background report. Then you need to get third-party verification. This is a very critical step. And then finally, you get your EPD published through an approved program operator, sometimes called a PO.
And you can do this with one-click LCA.
Sure, tools like OneClick LCA's EPD generator do streamline the process, and it enables you to take care of this in a matter of weeks, sometimes rather than months. I think the biggest hurdle is like just getting started. But once you start, you can see how fast and easy it can be.
Definitely. So earlier you mentioned third-party verification is absolutely crucial. How so? And on top of that, why you need to be careful about unverified environmental claims.
In the market, we're actually seeing more and more EPD-like documents, and they're not actually third-party verified. And that's a problem because without third-party verification, your environmental claims won't stand up to scrutiny. They won't meet ISO 14025 requirements. They won't count for certification credits. They won't satisfy procurement requirements.
So it's really about credibility and trust, right?
Yeah. You can think of verification like an audit. It sort of ensures that your data is accurate, your calculations are correct, the methods that you follow are according to required standards. Without verification, you're just kind of making up claims without backup. Verification might take more time, it might cost more money, but that's what gives your EPD its credibility and market value. And it's just not something to compromise on. It's really not worth the risk.
Yeah. So based on the market's current state, share with us where EPDs are heading.
EPDs are becoming the foundation of sustainable construction and manufacturing. An EPD is not just a document, it's a strategic tool. And they're used in BIM to optimize for carbon, they're used for carbon reduction targets, they're increasingly essential for project bidding. They're everywhere.
It sounds like they're becoming more integrated into the whole construction process.
Yeah, definitely. I'd say so. EPDs are on the rise and it makes it easier for people to compare products and make decisions. And regulations are only getting stricter. I mean, you see this in Europe, but this trend is going to spread globally. And the companies that understand this shift are already preparing. So they're not waiting for regulation to force their hand. They're using EPDs to innovate, to optimize their manufacturing processes and their products, and to position themselves as sustainability leaders and to do better. So that's where the industry is heading. And I think it's important to be a first mover to maintain competitive advantage and also future relevance.
Thank you, Abigail.
Yeah, cool. Thanks.